Thank you, resume. My name is Aprajita, and I'll explain you the procedure. Okay. Wait a minute. Effective techniques of writing resume. So there are a few things that have to be kept in mind while you're writing a resume. So in order to create an effective resume, there are a few pointers that are that I've mentioned here that you should know what the interviewer wants. Like the company you're interviewing for, you should know what the company expects of you, what type of, you know, behavior you're expected to present and what type of things and stuff you should have on your resume. And also have a clarity as to what you want. If you want to, you know, make a career in all this and just go in the cabin crew and do it directly. So you should know that you're making a career here and not here for the time being, or you're not doing an internship and you're here for a permanent job. So you should always be honest and you should write everything that is actually expected of you and not what you want to write. Okay, so now when you know your interests, you know their interests, you have to make sure that they align according to what is required. Because if you're writing, you like cooking and you're going for a cabin crew, then you cannot actually align them according to what they want. Okay. So you should always make sure that you are using your interest in order to, you know, align with their interests. Then you have to be very precise, very, very short. Like they should not be extra work, or, you know, the interviewer who is looking at your resume, he should not be like, what are you doing? And he should not be supposed to find what he needs to know. Instead, he should be served that in your resume. Also keep the text content very short, that I'll be explaining in the further slides. Then have good presentation. You know, there is a way that you present yourself. You have to look into the eye. You have to be very comfortable while talking to them. You don't have to, you know, show any nervous signs. Okay. And also there is one thing that I was told when I was creating resumes. So they told me that very basic things have the most impact, like the color you use for the resume, like the color I've used for my presentation. It has a very, very unique impact on the minds of the interviewer. So you have to be very careful as to what colors, what fonts, what size of the text you're using. It is very important while you do that. Okay. So next I'll be... This is a sample resume that I got from Google. I searched it and I got this thing. This is for a flight attendant. So this girl, she's done it very, you know, precisely, very sophisticatedly, but there are a few problems in this resume that I've explained further. So she's written a lot. There is a lot of text. You, when you're looking at this resume, you don't want to read it. Instead, you should have been served. Like the only thing I'm able to see here is flight attendant, work experience, and that. And I'm not interested in reading the bottom part. Then she's written a lot about herself. That is a professional profile. First of all, I don't understand what is a professional profile. She's talking about herself, but she's writing a professional profile. So that is also very questionable. Then she has rated her skills. Though she's rated a full grade, I'm still not very comfortable because I cannot trust her because I already don't employ her. So it is questionable as to how you present your, you know, positive parts. You know, there is some psychological effect as well. When you're presenting, if you don't tell your, you know, assets before your disadvantages, there'll be a lot of problem. Though she's not presented any of her disadvantages, still her assets are written at the bottom. That is also a problematic thing. So the positioning of the things in the file, it is very important. As to this, personal details. She's put her photo. So while you're in flight, you're applying for cabin crew, you should probably do it in your uniform, not like this. This is a very casual photo. Even if you're doing this, then don't use any filters. Like I've mentioned, don't use Huji, Snapchat, don't use any of that. Just put a proper picture that is very decent, very proper, very presentable. And, she's written height, age, arm reach, swimming ability, languages. I don't understand, like, why does she have to have swimming ability out here? Because that has to go in skills, not in her personal details. But still, if she's mentioned it here, it's okay. Personal details are not very proper. They're not very wrong. They're not presented very badly. So it's okay. So relevant data should be presented. professional profile. It's just written here. First of all, don't write professional profile because you don't know what you know what is related to your profession. But if you're writing about yourself and you're writing a professional profile, you should not. Instead, write what kind of person you are and how you are going to support the company and organization, how you're going to help it. Then also, when you're writing, there is a lot about language, the grammar you're using. If you're writing in past tense, that's not understandable. Many people have seen resumes while screening. Write in past tense. I was like that. I will be there like this. You don't. You have to write what you are right now. So keep it in present tense. Then keep it very respectable. Don't go around begging, but don't also go around being. Don't come out as a rude, arrogant, or uncivilized to a person. Like when she's reading, they're like they've got a lot of ego, they've got a lot of overconfidence and all that. That should not be in the minds of the person who's reading your resume. Then grammar, I already told you, and some people tend to mention jokes on themselves in the about bio. So it is not an Instagram profile. Do not go around writing jokes about yourself. Then contact. She's written very comfortably. But if you can write your Instagram handles, and Instagram handles have very direct relation to your job, only then write your Instagram handles. LinkedIn profile is a must. You must have it. You must keep it updated. And you should update it here like she's done it. This is very important. And email. Do not have a funny email. While you're working for corporate as well, you're always taught that the email should have a meaning and not a funny part. So even if you're keeping something, just make it very clear that there's nothing offensive for the people who are viewing it. There should not be anything religious. Do not use anything that can offend anyone. Just make sure you use your name, a bit of numbers. That's it. Even if you don't have such emails, kindly for the work profile, kindly create such emails. That they're very important. Then do not provide complete address in your resume, because unless you're employed, they'll not ask for your address. And you don't need to be over explaining here. And I already told you, relevant data should be mentioned. All right. You can always mention Twitter, because that's a trend, because people like to know what kind of person they are employing. So Twitter can tell you more about a person than Instagram, I think. This is key skills. So when you're writing about key skills, you have to keep the skills very precise and related to your job. This person has written customer service, communication, adaptability, teamwork, that are all important for the cabin crew. That are important, but she's rated her skills. Skills are very subjective. So I don't think rating them on your own whims and norms, it's very suitable for a person, because you might be overestimating yourself or you might be underestimating yourself. And if by chance you're underestimating yourself and you have a very short if you've put lower values here, this is going to be a problem for you later on. Because if you're not confident about yourself and the person gets to know that, they're going to use it against you and you can be rejected. So key skills you should not be using, you should not be rating them on your own. Put the skills. Instead, put an English word with the elementary level, or you can be excellent, or you're a master. You can write that like that, but do not use rating bullets like these. These are very, 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 they give a very wrong impression to the person. Okay, don't use statistics on this. And I would suggest you use this type of bullets for your language, because language you can actually rate. Because language, if it is rated, it is more advisable, because they'll know. If you know Korean, then you're writing Korean there, then they'll understand that you know this language. If you know French, you write that. But do not use this for the skills. I repeat, do not. Then work experience. The work experience part, she's written a lot. I'd say go for the keywords. She's written flight attendant, Etihad Airways, UK. She's written, it's okay. But try using keywords. I have to read all this. As an interviewer, I'm taking so many interviews in a day, and I have to read this. You've given me extra work while employing you. Why should I employ you? This is very questionable, and this goes directly into the brain of the person. So keep it short. use keywords and key achievement, you can write a sentence because of course you, your achievements are not understandable with keywords. Okay. So, and she's written 4 work experiences. I'll say go for 3 or basically 4 also will work, but keep the more priority, keep your priorities right, because if you write something that is very irrelevant to your job, that's not going to help you. That is going to be a problem and people are going to, you know, why do you give them more matter for them to question you over this? Because give them short, give them precise work and they'll give you the precise questions and you'll have the precise answers and it'll be very quick and very comfortable. Okay. Then education and training. I already mentioned that you should write only 2 educational degrees and most recent ones. And if you're doing extra courses, like if you've done anything like modeling or you've done anything extra beyond your education, that also you can actually write 2 things. Do not write more than that. Keep it short. I have written 5 things, but I'd say you write 4 things because the shorter it is, the more interested they'll be because you've written very precise and very quick and, you know, very crisp word. So they'll not have a problem with you and they'll be very comfortable in like what they want to talk to you about. You know what they're going to talk about and everything is quick and they're going to know what kind of person you are very soon, because if you're precise, you're very short, you'll understand. They'll understand what you're trying to present, what you're trying to ask and what you are offering and what they're ready to take. Then this is an expected resume, though it is very, you know, vacant because I have not written anything, you know, very specific according to the job, but this is how it should be seen. Like the bio, he's written the phone number, the name, the Instagram, the mail, everything is written on the upper right corner. That is the place you look at when you're done. Like first I start reading, I look at the face, I look at the name, then I look for about me. Then I go for education, and I see the career, I see the work experience, then I go for skills. And skills, if you could move upwards, it's okay. Skills, if they go at the career's timeline place, it's okay. They'll work fine for you. The languages, they're at the perfect place. Hobbies, nobody's interested, but they like to know. But no, like that is the only extra information you should be presenting on your resume. Then when it's all done, if they're interested in you, they'll directly go to your phone number and all that stuff so that they can contact you later. And the bio, because they'll like to know what is your age, what is your demographics and all that. So when you're doing it this way, it is very precise. Though it also, I've used a red color. This is red color. I would suggest if you're very confident about yourself, you should be using. I'd also suggest to study about color theory, because red color is the alarming color. Alarming color are very authentic colors. And when you're reading a resume, if it is in red, you understand that person is very confident about themselves. But if you're using gray color, they're saying that I am below you, but I'm ready to learn. There is this color theory. If one person has studied, they can use it in a lot of ways. The color theory, it is. The blue color, it is very soothing. The yellow color, it is very, you know, fun and jolly types of person, but yet interested in the job. Do not come out as, like, don't use pink and all that because it shows casualness. If you're using a bright magenta color, that is working. But if you're using a proper hot pink color and a cheap, like, weird taste, and what if the person does not like the color? What if? So always go for subtle colors. Yet very understand the logic behind the using of colors, because colors matter a lot. Then the font, I think this is very understandable font, but I'd request do not go for cursive or the weird colors like ink or very shabby types of, because people tend to not follow such languages and fonts, because very precise, very crisp block, it's better. Okay, so that is okay, that is done. And use a combination, light and dark, like this one. It is very good, but be sure that the color you're using presents you and not something that you're not. All right, then this is it. And also the things I've told, they're not benchmark for understanding. You can always be creative. Like if you want to use pictures, you want to use a clip art, you can always use that, but make sure you're keeping it minimalized and people understand what you're trying to do. Thank you.